Hello guys, KP Shamino here with a new video for Fishing Planet. So the last couple of weeks I'm trying to get better in competition. It's going really well at the moment, so I did already a couple of top 10s and a couple of top 20s. And today I was here for a competition. It's the biggest difference between two fish. So you need to get the biggest one and the smallest one. The smallest one was not really a problem, but the biggest one, I realized that I cannot get the unique Chinook anymore. So I started to fish a little bit, and after like 10 to 15 days, I decided to make a feeder fishing video for this lake, Alaska. How you need to get the unique Chinook. It was really strange. Because the position that I fished, so you guys can see it, on a sunny day between 5 and 8 a.m. I had 3 unis and 200 kilogram of fish. At evening, from 7 to 9 p.m. I didn't get unis, a couple of trophies and small fish. So I filled my net on a sunny day, that's 300 kilograms, in around 4 hours in game. So it's not bad, that's 43,000 currency. Can it compete with the sturgeon in California and the sturgeon blue catfish in Michigan? No. It cannot compete because I'm fishing with 3 rods at the moment, but it's something else. And then on a cloudy day between 7 and 9 p.m. I had 1 uni. The spot on a partly cloudy day is totally dead. Don't ask me why, but I couldn't get barely a Chinook on that position. So you guys can see it at the top. So my setups, because I'm going to show you guys first my setup. I wanted to show you guys my net, but the game was so laggy. I needed to restart, so I couldn't do anything about it. So you guys can see it. I'm using a level 40 setup, a level 50 setup, and I think a level 45 setup. So the guys that want to fish here, that just come to this lake and want to fish with bottom feeders, you can do it with your level 2 or with your gear. So the Mega Tuber 400, the Thunderspin 5500, the Mono 0.5, Sinker 175 gram, Mono Leader 0.4, Hook 6.0 and Shiners. That's what I'm using. Then this is the heavy one, that's the level 50, Heavy Chaser 310, Ambusher 9000, Fluoro 0.65, Sinker 225 gram, Mono Leader 0.5, Hook 6.0 en Large Minnows. Then the 6 is Heavy Chaser 290, Ambusher 9000, Fluoro 0.65, Sinker 200, Mono Leader 0.5 en Hook 6.0 Large Minnows. I don't see a difference between Large Minnows and Shiners. The only thing that I saw was that I had 3 uniques on a sunny day. And 2 of them were with the large minnow. So, but you cannot say it, it's better by that. You need to do it like 10, 15 days. Always remember, guys, every sunny day is not the same sunny day. So you are going to get sunny days at the morning that it's very bad too. You got that with the sturgeon fishing too. If you don't have 14 Celsius from 2 to 4 p.m., 4 a.m. at night, it's not going to go that well. 14 Celsius is the best. So in even sunny days you got different in how the fish bites. So now it's time to go fish, because I'm going to show you guys the cloudy day. So where do you need to go? You need to go here to the hunter's cabin. And I'm going to forward the time to 7 p.m. on a cloudy day, because if I... Yeah, here it is. So the next day, so I need to use a bait gun, but that's not a problem. So, but first of all, I'm going to the position. So where do you need to go? And it seems that now my game is stable again, because the previous video, it's the second time that I record the video. It was, I couldn't do almost, yeah, it's happening again. You guys can, Alaska was always a very bad place to make videos. The pike, where the pike is sitting in Michigan, just the same story. It was never that stable, this place. But now it seems it's okay. So we need to go to the third island. And you guys already can see that my buoys are here. So here you can see it. So first of all, try to put the rod pot sideways. Because You are going to drift otherwise. If it goes sideways, it's a little bit better. It's very strange, but if you throw your weight, your bottom weight, right off your top of your rod, so to here, it's not going to drift. If you throw it straight and to the left, it's going to drift. Don't ask me why that is, but yeah, I think it's in the program. So we are going to put the rod pot on the ground. Let me have a look. Yeah, this is good. The further, yeah, here we go. So now we are going to put the time at 7 p.m. So this, okay, and now we are going to throw first the small rod into the water. So this is the distance, 20-25 meters until 30 you can go. So if you want to go with the bobber, it's very easy. You just throw on this position, 25 meters, maximum depth 6-0 shiners, and you let it float all the way to here and you're going to catch the unique Chinook too. So let's throw this one over here. And let's do control one. It's very strange, but I think they changed the stuff because now I need to use shift 1, 2, 3 to go around. In the past it was so easy. I don't understand why they switched that system. In the past you just needed to push the number of your rod and you just pick it up. Now you need to do shift 2. So yeah, not sure why they did it. Okay, let's put this here and then we are going to get number 6. And let's throw this over here. So you guys can see right away what the distance is. So yeah, 27, and I already got a bite. So I'm hoping on very good activity. I think it's number 5, no? Okay, let's do it like this. Yeah, number 5 and number 6. So I think that number 6 is going, if I see the line right, but we need to wait a little bit, so. It can take some time. They take the time, and I think, yeah, number 5 is gone. Okay, let's have a look what we got. Yeah, I think it's a normal one, this one. Yeah, it's taking a little bit of drag. Is it already a trophy? Or is it maybe the unique right away? Let me have a look. Yeah, trophy. Nice 14 kilogram. That's a good starter. So that's not bad. Let's throw it back on the same position. There we go. Control 2. And I think, yeah, there is a fish nibbling on the 6 now. Okay, there goes 6. That's nicely. Yeah, let's have a look what we got here. Yeah, this is a normal one. Yeah, it's a normal one. But you guys can see it goes really quick. So the fishing. So if you fish in the best time. So there are only two good times in this spot. So for the other timeframes, you need to find other spots. I think there are other spots that you can get them, because normally unique time zone is on partly cloudy in the morning too. In the evening, I think you can get uniques too in a sunny, but I can be totally wrong. But I only got uniques morning sunny and cloudy 7 to 9 p.m. On the other days, I didn't get one or times. So number 5 is going again. So it seems that they like the large minnows. And this is a fat one. Yeah, it's a unique. This is a first unique already. And the main problem is that if you got now a fish on, in the past you can just put it in the rod pot. But that seems, yeah, you cannot do that anymore. It's possible it's only in Alaska, but if I put it in the rod pot and I just take the other one, you're going to lose the fish. So I hope that I get this one really quick in, because they work with waste uniques. So most of the time if you get one, a little bit later you get the next one. This is a fat one, check this. Very fat unique. So I need to go really quick. 25 kilograms. Number 6. Okay. That was a very nice fish, guys. Very nice fish. This is a trophy. Or a normal one. No, it's a normal one. So here we go. And there is something not right with number 3. I think that at a cloudy day, at the evening, they don't like the shiners. You guys can see it. My small rod, so the lowest level one, is not getting a bite. But the only difference that I can see is I got shiners on that rod. So they don't like the shiners, I think. So let's do one more wave of bites and then I'm going to end the video. Because I got the unique, that was really good and a very nice one. Let's have a look. So on this spot, if you got a sunny day, and a sunny day, it works really well. You can just fish 3 hours. You got your cooldown on the forward time. And you can just go to the next day on a sunny day. On a cloudy day, it's a little bit problematic, because you can go to the morning, but then you need to pay a bait coin. So you need to do something on in the morning on a cloudy day. I'm not sure, maybe Dolly Varden or something. Or the smaller sockeye, I don't know. But it's how it is. Let's have a look that the next wave is incoming. And now I go to number 3. So the Chinook realized that they like shiners too. That's always good. So they are now nibbling on number 3. So I'm expecting some fish on it. Number 5 is going too. I think number 6 is going too. So this can be very problematic for me. Yeah, number 6, that's good. Let's have a look. Is it normal? Yeah, I'm going to drag this one really quick in. There we go. I'm not going to re-throw number 6. Because I'm going to miss otherwise the other fish on number 5. So number 5 now. Let me have a look. Normal one too? Or is it a trophy? No, it's a normal one. Here we go. So that's how much? 17 kilograms in 30 minutes in game. So yeah, it's not bad. It's not going bad. I think it's a very good day. So let's put this back. Yeah, and number 3. Shiner is a no-go, guys. Shiners is a no-go. That's always the beauty with the feeders at the moment. So if you want to find some spots, you can just throw like your feeders everywhere and just check like 3 spots at the same time. In the past, it was always with the bobber or the lure. It took a lot of more time. Now you can do the same work in like 1/3 of the time, because you can just throw the feeders away to a position. That's really cool. So that makes life a lot easier to find the spots. So what do we get at the moment? How much money with premium? 10,000. So 1 unique, 1 trophy and 4 normal Chinooks. And you guys can see it right away. It's all on large minnows. So I'm going to do one more bite and then I'm going to end the video. So you guys know everything, I think. The setup, the position, the time frames, you can see at the top right. So that's very handy. Where you need to fish, you know it too. The meters that you need to make. I cannot say more. So for partly cloudy, you need to go around. Maybe on partly cloudy. I think partly cloudy is at the morning really good. So maybe it's at the end of the river. I know there is a unique trophy spot too. I know over there, here is a unique trophy spot too. a unique trophy spot. What I'm saying, a unique spot. So here I had like a couple of trophy Chinooks too. But maybe that are the positions for partly cloudy. I don't know. And I hope that I can. Normally I got one more wave in this hour of biting. So it's around 40, no 20 minutes in game. So we need to wait a little bit. It's a waiting game. Feeder fishing is a waiting game. So normally in Europe we just take a tent. We just start drinking beer. We put the feeders out. And yeah, if you get like one or two bites in an all day, you were very drunk, but you didn't catch a lot of fish. So that's how it works sometimes. I never did it in my life, but I went a couple of times watching my friend how he did it. And it's very boring, I need to say, if you need to do it in real life. But yeah, it's fun because you can do a lot of other stuff. So come on, fish. Give me one more wave for the video and then I can end the video. So let's go around just for luck. You guys can see, check. If you put the rod pot like this, you guys can see that my lines are nicely straight still. So they stay at the position. So that's very important, because if they start drifting in the old lakes, it's a problematic because you need to be at the position, otherwise you're not going to catch a fish. So I can do really quick the meanwhile that we are waiting. So if you want to go here with the bobber, just go with the Brutos. So green beer I got at DLC, 250 meters, 6-0, so just a very good setup. And you just need to throw on that position. And then you just need to let it drift the whole way to here. And you're going to catch it too. But I got now a bite. So I need to interrupt the bobber fishing for a brief moment. It was a strong bite, this one. Yeah, he's gone. What the fuck? It sometimes happens. I think I was a little bit too soon or a little bit too late. I'm not sure what it was. Or maybe just a little bit too noob, that's possible too. I'm going to put this away, because I'm just going to get this in. Then I'm going to show you guys really quick how you need to throw with the bobber. And then I'm going to end the video. So that's how you need to do it, guys. I cannot say more, you got all the info. Yeah, what am I doing now at the moment? Jesus Christ. Yeah, fat fingers, you know. Okay, so for bobber fishing you do this, so you just throw here. I think that's 26-27 meters. Maximum depth 6-0. I'm going with shiners, that's maybe not the best plan. Because it seems that shiners is not so good at the moment, so that's what you need to do. And then you just need to let it drift. You can even run a little bit with the bobber. Just like that, and that's how you are going to get the unique Chinook too. So yeah, that was it for the video, guys. Thanks for watching. Have fun with unique Chinook salmon in Alaska, and I see you guys in the next video. By the way, I was invited previous week to play Warhammer Chaosbane. It's a very cool game because I played it already a lot. It's a little bit like Diablo 3. And on Thursday, 1 a.m. PST, I'm going to release a couple of videos because I already made them. Because at the moment we are still in embargo. That means we cannot publish it, but we can make videos. But it's a really cool game. So next Thursday, you guys will see it, how it is. And I'm going to get this fish in. Was it too soon again? No, it's just on time. Let's have a look. A normal again, I guess. No, it's a trophy. I think it's a trophy. Yeah, he's getting... Oh. Let's go backwards. Here we go. Shitfish. Okay, it's a normal one. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye-bye.